Okay, so we've covered the basics of HTML already, but this is just a little refresher just to get us up and going again. Open up your web page by getting through to where you've saved it. That type of file there with a little sort of bit of paper with lines on is a notepad file. So when you open that up, you'll get direct access to your code that you did before with notepad. If you don't see that, if you only see the ones with the Internet Explorer on, just means it's been saved as a web page. But what we can do is get the code from that. So the way to do that is if you just open up Notepad just as per normal, just by typing in Notepad and open it up. And if you just do a file open and then just browse through to wherever your web page is saved. And what you will have to do is just on the drop down here, just make sure you select all files, and then you'll see everything that's in your folder where you've saved it. And literally, you just click on the one you want to open and click open, and it'll open up in Notepad. Okay, so you can get it in one of two ways, either by the original Notepad file or by the web page, but you have to open Notepad first if you do that. So, next step is just a quick refresher of what's going on here, really. So anything with a little bracket around it is called a tag, okay? And the majority of tags have to have an opening and a closing tag. So to give you an example here, HTML, that's the opening tag, and that says to the computer that I want to program a web page, I want to code a web page. So that's the opening tag. And right at the very bottom, it's got a closing tag. And if you remember, the way to sort of know that it's a closing tag is it's got this little dash there. Okay, if it doesn't have that, it won't recognize that it's a closed tag, so the tag won't work properly. You can experiment by taking it out and trying to open it up as a web page if you want to. So the HTML tag tells it that we want to make a web page. The title tag is what appears at the very, very top of the web page when you create it. So that's the title of the page, and again, you can put anything in there that you want, but again, it must be opened with that tag and closed with that tag with the little dash in there. And the body is quite an important one because anywhere in between these two tags is basically where the content of your web page is going to go. So at the moment, the only thing I have on my web page is something that says Hello World. Okay. If I was to put anything outside of these two body tags, it wouldn't display properly. And again, do experiment, put something in there, or give that a couple of extra spaces, put something in there, or anything below there, put something in there. Okay, and just see what happens. Basically, you'll find that you need to have the content of your web page in between these two body tags. And as you'll find, as you add more and more, this gets expanded quite a long way. But as long as it's in between the two tags, you should be perfectly fine. So just as a quick refresher, to turn it actually into a web page, all you need to do is go to File, Save As, give it a name, okay, and just make sure at the end you type .html, because this tells it that we want to turn it into a web page rather than a notepad file, which it is at the moment. So I'm just going to click Save there. And what we should have is this, which appears with a little E, which says it's a web page. Okay, and if we open it up, it should be what I've just described. So this bit at the top, my first effort, and a Hello World in the body of the page. Okay, so let's just check that out. So there we go, Hello World. Okay, so not the most exciting web page, but the next video tutorial will have a look at how to make it a bit more interesting using HTML code.